Hey guys, Metal Jesus here, and well, E3 2021 is officially over, and I don't know about you, but I was blown away by all of the game reveals that happened this last week. Man, there has been so many AAA titles announced, so many of them I'm excited to check out when they finally ship, so many of them I've added to my wish list. I'm sure you're like me, where you're just like, wow, okay. Great time to be a gamer, but the thing about E3 is beyond the AAA games, there are literally hundreds of other games that get released that, you know, could potentially be missed. And so in this video, I'm going to share some of them that I think, you know, look interesting. I think they're worth keeping an eye on. So let's take a look. The first game I want to talk about is called Trek to Yomi or Yomai. I'm not entirely sure how to pronounce that, but this was revealed during the Devolver Digital Showcase and it looks stunning. This is a 2D action fighting game where you play a samurai that is trying to avenge, I believe it's either your family or your entire village, but the standout feature here, as you can see from this footage, is just the visuals. It looks like an old school Kurosaka film. It looks beautiful. I love its art style. So this one definitely caught my eye. Don't know much about it yet, but I'm sure we're going to learn more. It comes out in 2022. I am a huge Metal Slug fan, and I was really surprised to see that there is going to be a Metal Slug Tactics game coming soon. This was a total surprise. I don't think anybody saw this coming. This is pretty cool because it's going to retain that classic Metal Slug pixelated style. That artwork is iconic and it looks like they're keeping that and also the sound effects, but they're basically just doing a tactics game, which I think is amazing. They're also saying that there's gonna be roguelike elements in this game. So I assume that's probably gonna be procedurally generated levels if you want them. Could be very interesting. So it's cool to see them taking the Metal Slug franchise and trying something new with it. So this was a very cool thing to get revealed. I'm excited. Broken Pieces is a game that really caught my eye. So this is an upcoming adventure game that looks like a combination of, say, Silent Hill, maybe a little bit of Alan Wake in there, maybe some of The Longest Journey. So in this game, you play as a young woman who travels to France and she gets stuck in a time loop where she lives out the same day over and over. Now, from the trailer, it looks like some really weird stuff ensues, but unfortunately, not that much else is known about this game. I think you'll probably agree with me, though, that this game looks great. So I've got my eye on it. I'm very curious about it. Next up is a game called Nico Ghost Jump. So this is a platforming game that combines 2D and 3D gameplay at the push of a button. And the thing is, you're gonna wanna be able to do that because you'll get stuck depending on the perspective that you're currently at. So you'll change it from 2D to 3D and then suddenly you can get through it, or maybe you'll be stuck in 3D and you'll switch over to 2D and you can continue on. Plus, they also hide hidden loot depending on the perspective that you're in. So really interesting game. I like the concept. I'd be curious to see how it turns out. This is coming to PC, Xbox, PlayStation, Nintendo Switch, and also the Atari VCS. I thought that was pretty hilarious. Here's a sequel to a game I've talked about previously before. This is Project Warlock 2. And as you can see by this gameplay footage, it has glorious old school style graphics. It's basically a first person shooter. And essentially what happens in this, it picks up right after the end of the first game. However, the difference here in the sequel is that they're adding a bunch of verticality to the level design. The other thing is that it's gonna have 3 episodes and each of those episodes you'll play as a different warlock, each having their own magic powers. The first game was brutal, awesome, and fun, and I can't wait to check out the sequel. This is a trailer that really caught my eye. This is Toy Soldiers HD. So this is a third-person action strategy game that takes place during World War I. I guess this game originally came out on Xbox Live Arcade, I assume on the Xbox 360, although I completely missed it at the time, which is a real bummer because it looks pretty cool. I like how you can zoom out for a more overall tactical view of it. And then it seems like you can zoom in and take control of single units. So that's pretty cool. Now, this version here is going to have basically all new content, new graphics, expanded gameplay. They say they're going to improve the controls and much more. This new HD version is going to come to the PlayStation, Xbox, Switch, and PC in August. We don't have to wait very long. Here's a game that my friends and I were referring to as, oh, that paper airplane game. Well, it's called Life Slide, and essentially, as you see here, you are controlling a paper airplane that is flying through these levels. Now, it looks fairly simplistic, but when I dug deeper, it looks like there's quite a bit going on here. For instance, each one of the 28 stages in this game actually represent the stages of real life. So there's almost like an RPG element to the game. Again, kind of trying to parallel life or something like that. Sounds really interesting, but I guess each one of those stages has their own unique challenge. Also, you have 6 different paper airplanes to choose from and upgrade. Yeah, it just looks like a really interesting idea. I love games that kind of do something different. Now, I guess this game is currently out on Apple Arcade, but it's going to be coming to Steam in August. So no word on a console release, but I'm sure that's probably being looked at. Here's another first-person game that really caught my attention. It's called Fallen Aces. And so essentially what's going on here, it's a first-person beat-em-up brawler shooter. And its whole premise is it's taking place with gangsters. And I love its hand-drawn style there. So it's almost like a, kind of retro-inspired hand-drawn first-person shooter. So pretty interesting game. Now, I guess what's kind of cool about this is that it supports different gameplay styles. So you can play through a level stealth, or you can go just guns blazing. It kind of gives you that sort of freedom. Pretty cool looking game. I'm curious to check it out. Here's another game that really caught my attention with its visuals. That is called Silt. And in this game, you play as a deep sea diver in this kind of black and white adventure here. Now, if you look at the trailer closely, what's going on is that your character is either possessing or maybe transferring the consciousness of yourself to creatures in the game to then solve puzzles and progress. It's definitely got a kind of weird horror vibe to it, so I'm curious about it. It looks pretty cool, and I guess it's going to be coming to PC in 2022. I also want to mention Limited Run Games because they had a great showing at E3. A couple Castlevania games in there, Zombies Ate My Neighbors, things like that. But there were two announcements that blew my mind. The first one is that they're going to be releasing a physical version of Strife on Switch. This was a total surprise to me because Strife is a really cool first-person shooter RPG that came out, gosh, probably 20 years ago, maybe even a little bit longer. I have the original physical version of this. I had no idea that they're going to be releasing a new version of it. So I just kind of want to point that out, that if you like old school first person shooters, you're probably going to want to pick this one up. It looks pretty cool. But probably the biggest surprise of all of E3 was that Limited Run Games was going to put out a physical version of Plumbers Don't Wear Ties for the PC, Switch, PlayStation 4, and PlayStation 5. When I saw this, one, I didn't believe it, and two, I thought it was hilarious. So if you're not familiar with Plumbers Don't Wear Ties, it is a game that came out on the 3DO. It is considered probably one of the worst video games of all time, and that is completely deserved. it is billed as an adult-oriented romantic comedy. It is horrible. Now, I've actually played this game. I sat down with a friend of mine who owns a copy of it. We were hanging out at his house a couple years ago, drinking some beers, playing this game for the first time, and we were laughing our asses off. It's so bad. So it's kind of funny that Limited Run is bringing this out. Again, I was completely shocked that they are doing that, but it's also hilarious at the same time. I definitely want my own copy of it. Take that for what it is. You're hearing this from a guy who has a Cannonball Run poster hung up in my game room. So I like things that are cheesy, but man, this was hilarious. Another game that got revealed and also released during E3, I want to mention it here because it's freaking awesome. Let me see if I can pronounce it. It is Mushihime-sama. Mushihime-sama. Boy, I hope I got that right. All you have to know is that its English translation is Bug Princess. So Bug Princess is a game I've been playing for years now. I originally played it on my iPad, and then I got the physical version of it on the Xbox 360. That's because in Japan, they got the physical version of it. This is one of my favorite cave shoot-em-ups of all time. And again, I was blown away when I got the announcement that they were releasing this on the Switch, like the day of. So this is out currently. It's a fantasy-based shoot-em-up, as you see here. What's cool about it is that they've taken the arcade version of it and added a bunch of extra stuff. So they've added a, I don't know if it's a novice mode or a beginner mode, but basically a way where you can play it that is much easier than the arcade, so that way you can kind of build up to the difficulty. And then they also add in a bunch of stuff if you are really good at it. So if you want to get destroyed in this bullet hell game, you can. This is basically a shoot 'em up for everybody. And it's pretty cool. So definitely check it out. And then the last thing I want to mention, because you could have easily missed it if you weren't paying attention during the Far Cry 6 reveal, is at the end of that, they were talking about some of the DLC that they're going to put out, and they announced that they're going to put out a remastered version of Far Cry 3, Blood Dragon. I saw that, I was like, oh my god, this is so awesome. So if you're not familiar with Blood Dragon, it is an over-the-top love letter to 1980s cheese. I mean, it's parodying 80s movies, 80s pop culture, 80s video games. It's freaking awesome. And so this was a total surprise to see. It'll be interesting to learn if they're gonna just maybe have it run on the Far Cry 3 engine, or if they're gonna remaster it using the Far Cry 6 stuff. Is it gonna look a little bit different? Maybe, I don't know, higher resolution or something? I don't know. All we know is the teaser, but that was enough to get me really excited. But anyways, guys, that is some of the E3 reveals that you may have missed. That was my list right there. Those were the things that kind of piqued my interest, but I would love to know down in the comments, what piqued your interest? What are some of the little kind of lesser known things that got announced during E3? Post and share down below. And as always, I want to thank you for watching my channel. Thank you for subscribing, and take care.